Today we will start the basics of MS Excel. So for this, first of all you have to know right what are the steps to start the MS Excel. So to start the MS Excel, you have to first of all click on the start button, then click on the all programs, then click on the Microsoft Office, and then click on the Microsoft Excel. After clicking on the Excel, this is the screen that appears in front of you. This is the interface of Microsoft Excel. So in this, let me introduce you the basis of the cells worksheet. So the screen which appears in front of you is called worksheet. By default, the Excel consists of the three sheets, sheet 1, sheet 2, and sheet 3. So these are the three sheets that are there in the MS Excel by default. Now, what is worksheet? The screen that appears when we open the MS Excel is called worksheet. So in this sheet, all these are known as cells. The intersection of rows and columns is known as cell. There are so many cells in the Excel, but the cell on which we click, that will becomes the active cell. All are cell, but the cell on which we click to write upon something, any data, that is called the active cell. Or you can say any cell with a dark boundary is called the active cell. So this is cell. Cell is what? Cell is the intersection of rows and column, and active cell is the cell with the dark boundary on which we have to write upon is called active cell. Now the next thing is, there are the alphabets written on the top, A, B, C, D, E, F. All these are known as column headings. All these are known as column headings. And the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that are known as the row headings. Repeating, the A, B, C, D. These are known as column headings. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and all these numbers are known as the row heading. The combination of all these is known as cell. Now, we can identify the cell address also. Suppose I have click on this cell and this becomes my active cell now. Now, to identify the cell address, we have to just first of all look at the column alphabet and then the row number. The column is F and the number is 8. So cell address is F8. It is also visible here in the name box. This is the name box where the cell address is displayed. Suppose again I am clicking here. This is my cell address, my active cell. The active cell address is K7. It is displayed here also in the name box. So this is how we can identify the cell address. Now the further, we can say that suppose we have to come on the sheet 2. Then we click on the sheet 2 and we can do what the work we want to work upon. Now in the same manner, if we want to work upon the sheet 3, we can click on the sheet 3 and we can start doing the work on the sheet number 3. Now coming back on the sheet number 1, suppose I have entered the numbers. I'm just entering the list as the marks. Marks I have entered here as the title. Now I want to increase the size of the marks. So what I will do, I will click on the font size box, and clicking on the font size, we can increase the size of the word written here. Now you can see the marks is written in F and that is coming out of the margin. So I have to increase the column width here so that it comes in the single column. and this is marks written here. And marks address is F5. F is on the top and 5 is the number there. So name box is also there, appearing the marks as the cell address F5. So today we will learn about the some formulas in the MS Excel. For those formulas to apply, I have to enter some numbers just to tell you how to apply the formula. Suppose I am writing the numbers here 45, 56, 38, 28, 50, 100, and then I am having the number 26. Suppose these numbers are there with me in the list, and I have to do the sum of all these numbers. First of all, I want to increase the size of all these numbers so that it is visible to me, and for that purpose I have selected all the numbers. After selecting, go on the font size and choose the size whatever you want in the font size box. This is the size I want. And if you want to do the formatting of the cell, I can do the formatting like this. In the marks, I can fill the color by clicking on the fill color box and just click on the color that you want to choose. This is my formatting of the marks. And I want to fill the color of all these boxes also. So I will again select the boxes of the numbers and go on the fill color tool and select the marks color that I want there to be. I suppose I want this marks, this color in this box. Okay. Now the marks are visible like just in a single line, that are not visible in the separate lines. To give it in the tabular form, so what I have to do, again I have to select the numbers and give it to the border. For the border, after selecting the data, I have to click on the border button. On the border button arrow of the border button, I have to click. From that arrow of the border, we have the button of the all borders. When we click on this button, this will appear as the tabular form. This is called the how to give the border to the table. Now I have to perform some functions in front of you. The first one is sum. Again, the size is very small, so I have to increase the size. Again, click on the font size button and choose the size whatever you want. I want that to 20, and this is the sum. First, to calculate any formula, first of all you have to choose the cell where you want the result. Make the cell active where you want the result. I have put my cursor here, and this is now my active cell. To begin with any formula, the first rule is always start with the equal to symbol. I have put it there, the equal to symbol, and then write the function name, that is sum. Sum is a function name. Start the parenthesis and select the range of which you want to take out the sum. And now F7 colon F13, this is called the range of the numbers of which I want to take the sum. Now close the parenthesis and press the enter key. This is the total of all these numbers. Again, I am using the size of this one. So this is the total of all these numbers. So again, I am just repeating you with the formula of the sum. You can watch on the top, this is the formula bar. Start with the equal to symbol, write the function name sum, start the parenthesis, select the range and close the parenthesis and press the enter key. In this way, you can find out the sum of the numbers. Now, another formula today we have to discuss is maximum. Maximum number I have to search for. So this is the what's the formula to put here is, so maximum written is the small f in the small size. I am increasing the size of the maximum number is. So again you have to click on the cell where you want to put your result, your value. So I am making it my cursor this active cell. So again, to start any formula, the rule is same, start with the equal to symbol, and to find out the maximum number, write the function name max, start the parenthesis, select the range of which you want to find out the maximum number, close the parenthesis and press the enter key. The maximum number is 100 is in the above list, and it is obvious to all that in this list the number, the biggest number, the maximum number is 100. So it is the formula for the maximum. Now further, the another formula I have to tell is minimum. So minimum, the formula I have to discuss now. Again, the size of maximum is small, so I will select the minimum and go on the font size and select the size whatever you want. I want that to be 20. This is the size of the minimum. And to put the formula of the minimum, the rule again is same, start with the equal to symbol, write the function name min, start the parenthesis, and you have to select the range from which you want to find out the minimum number, close the parenthesis and press the enter key. This is the minimum number among the list provided to us. This is how you can take out the minimum of the numbers given to you. The another formula today we will discuss is average. Average we have to discuss. Again, the size is small. I have to again put the font size, clicking on the font size box and selecting the size as 20. And to put the formula of the average, the rule again is same. Start with the equal to symbol, write the function name average, start the parenthesis, select the range, close the parenthesis, press the enter key. This is the average of these numbers. So again, I am going to the font size box and increasing the size to 20. So these four formulas we have discussed today: sum, maximum, minimum, average. I hope you all have understood the concept nicely, and